Welcome to the Family History Gem, produced by the Division of Genomic Medicine at UC Davis. This module will focus on family history taking and how to use family history as a screening tool. Taking a comprehensive family history is a critical part of health diagnosis as it can provide valuable information about the patient. The information could help guide a decision towards or away from consideration of genetic conditions. If a patient is affected by a disease, information about treatment options and management are essential to provide to the patient as soon as possible. If a patient is predisposed to a particular condition, early identification of increased risk of disease can allow you and your patients to work together to reduce risk of the disease through lifestyle changes and increased surveillance. This module will walk you through the basics of how to take a comprehensive family history, including which questions to ask in order to elicit the most informative data, how to draw a pedigree to depict family history, and how to use a pedigree as a risk assessment tool. Let's put this information in the context of a real-life scenario that you might encounter on the job. Imagine a patient who presents at the clinic with chronic migraines, low energy, fatigue, and is small for his age. You would like to rule out whether the migraines could be due to something genetic, so you need to take a family history and put the information into a pedigree. Let's talk about where to begin with drawing your pedigree. A comprehensive family history includes at least three generations. For example, let's start with the patient, then his siblings. Next, we can draw in their parents, any of their parents' siblings, who in this case are your patient's uncles. We can draw in any cousins, as well as your patient's grandparents. It may be easier to list out all the members of the nuclear family first, and then go back and ask about details of each one. Some details you should ask about each family member include age, country of origin or ethnic group, current health status, age of onset of disease, ages and causes of death, and any pregnancy outcomes. Once you've recorded this information, you can begin to look for patterns that may be indicative of a genetic link. Here are a few red flags that could increase the likelihood of the presence of a genetic condition: family history, ethnic predisposition, consanguinity, other relatives with the same disorders, early age of onset, diagnosis in the less often affected sex, absence of risk factors, malformations, developmental delays, growth abnormalities, recurrent pregnancy losses, or bilateral occurrences. The rule of twos helps simplify this list. Family health history questions that result in answers using the descriptor 2, T-O-O, or 2, T-W-O, may indicate a genetic condition. As you take your patient's family history, you notice that your patient's mom, both uncles, and his grandmother all reported chronic migraines. All have poor hearing. The patient's mom and grandmother also have experienced vision loss. The patient's younger sisters are only 2 months and 14 months old, and both are significantly smaller than they should be for their age. Both are unusually fussy. One may have had a seizure recently. Let's look at this list by family member. You recall that pedigrees in which two or more relatives have the same or related disorders is a red flag for a genetic link, as is growth restriction. You draw out a pedigree denoting all relatives who have complained of migraines, including the sisters who are fussy, but too young to know whether it could be due to a migraine. As a reminder, some of the more common inheritance patterns include autosomal dominant, autosomal recessive, X-linked dominant, X-linked recessive, Y-linked, and mitochondrial. You are able to gather more information about the patient's family to increase the size of the pedigree. Do you see any patterns? Press pause if you would like more time to think about this. You can't, with absolute certainty, rule out any patterns of inheritance, since in some cases, not every person in the family exactly fits the pattern of inheritance due to a variety of factors. However, you notice that this pattern matches what you would expect from mitochondrial inheritance. Mitochondrial DNA is only passed down by the mother to all of her offspring, and only her daughters will pass their mitochondrial DNA on to their offspring. Mitochondrial DNA is not inherited from fathers. You investigate mitochondrial conditions further and realize that mitochondrial disorders can affect hearing and vision loss, cause migraines, and are sometimes associated with restricted growth. This confirms that you've likely correctly identified the pattern of inheritance. You order a mitochondrial DNA panel for your patient and results come back positive. You and your patient's family can now discuss treatment options and lifestyle changes to improve your patient's health and well-being. If you would ever like help determining whether a condition could be genetic, the Division of Genomic Medicine is here to help. Our clinic is located in the Mind Institute on the medical campus in Sacramento. You can refer patients to our genomic medicine clinic, visit our website, or call us with questions or to speak with a genetic counselor.